Is your bottle opener just downright horrible to use? Is it terribly unergonomic? Does it make your drink taste bad? Introducing...
What's up everybody, I'm Tyler Bell. Today making an over-engineered bottle opener. Alright, here's what I got for the pneumatic system. A 1-inch stroke pneumatic cylinder, a solenoid valve, an air reservoir, a check valve, and a quick disconnect fitting. And I'll have links to all the products down in the description. That was a mistake.
I messed up doing this round over. This side turned out okay, but when I did the opposite side, the bearing was riding on the previous radius.
So next I'm gonna make the trigger for this guy, and I'm gonna shape it out of this block of aluminum. But first I need to rip it to width to fit in between the two cover plates. So previously, all the video I've shot on this channel have been shot on this guy, little Canon G7X, and today that changes. But I'm in the middle of shooting this video, so here is me introducing my new camera. So I've got a tap drill set up here because I'm punching through both plates at the same time. After this operation, I'll go back and full size the clearance fit holes. Okay, so I'm gonna try and bend 1¼ inch radius in the middle here because two of the bottles I'm sampling each are at 1¼ inch diameter, 1¼ inch down from the bottom of the cap, which is perfect. test number one after building the restraint, running off just the cylinder because we have the check valve. 3, 2, 1. That worked so good. Dang. Dude, take it easy. I know I could have cut those out by hand. I've just always wanted to try that technique. So I want to try a technique called engine turning. I'm gonna take these Scotch-Brite plugs and then glue them to the head of this bolt. I'm just using this bolt as an arbor because my drill chuck only holds half inch diameter stuff. This head is 3/4, which is what I want. I'm gonna try and glue it on with this tape. It's like a tacky tape. Adam Savage called it butyl, so we'll see if it works.
That works a lot better than I thought.
Test, I'm gonna try a couple different bottle shapes.
So how I do this is I set the cap on top of the finger and then I let the restraint do its job once the bottle travels up. So it looks like Coca-Cola fits, but Pepsi and Fanta both have a little bit too long of a neck. What I'm gonna do is move this retainer down a hole.
So there it is, the pneumatically actuated rapid and mobile bottle cap removal device, or PARMP GERD. One of the reasons for this project was I wanted an excuse to learn pneumatic systems, and also it was just an engineering challenge for me to figure out. I did make it through the project with only one bottle breaking. If you enjoyed this video, you're welcome to subscribe. One way to really help me out is to share this video with a friend. So that's it for this one, guys. See you next time.